Hello and welcome to Jobs and Education. Do subscribe and share my videos. This is your Mahesh Dole. In this class, I would like to explain about the production drawing of non-return valve. Very important. So what is the function of a non-return valve? Non-return valve is also called as a check valve, a clack valve, non-return valve, a reflux valve, retention valve, or one-way valve. So it is a valve that normally allows fluid to flow through it in only one direction. This non-return valve is allowing the fluid to flow through only one direction. That's why it is called as non-return valve or one-way valve, or sometimes we can call it as clack valve or check valve also. This is the question of non-return valve in production drawing. It is going to ask like, draw the component drawing views, limits, fits and tolerances, geometrical tolerances, surface finish and process sheet. These are the parts. So six parts are there in the question of the non-return valve. Look at this. The first one is body. This is the indication of first number, that is body. Second one is cover. Third is a stud with a nut. Fourth is valve. Fifth part is set screw. Sixth part is valve seat. These are the six parts of non-return valve. So very important to understand that, looking at the question and understanding how many parts are given in the question. So here we understood that six parts given, and that too we need to observe where are the six parts are there in the question. So after looking at the question, this is the front view, this is the top view. After looking at this question, we understood six parts, right? So we need to move on to the first one, that is drawing the component drawing views. Means dividing this assembled figure into individual parts or component drawing, or simply we cannot say it as part drawing. So this is a component drawing or part drawing or individual parts. Let's see, out of these six parts here, this is the first part, this is the second part, front view and top view, this is fifth part, this is third part, this is a sixth part, this is fourth part. We know first part is the body, this is major part. Second is cover, this is a cover, front view and top view. And third one is stud with nut. Where is the stud with nut? This is third part, stud with nut. And fourth part is valve. This is the fourth part, valve. And fifth part is set screw, this is set screw. And sixth part is valve seat, this is valve seat. So divided this complete figure into six individual parts. So as given in the question, like body, cover, stud with nut, valve, set screw and valve seat. So after dividing individual parts, here important thing is that we need to maintain the given dimensions as it is in the question. If the question given that this is a 140 length, we should maintain 140 length only. If the diameter of this circle is given in the question as 190, means we should maintain 190 only here. Mean whatever the dimensions given in the question, indicating those dimensions here very important. Another important fact is that sometimes question may ask that draw the sectional front view or draw the sectional top view of some of the figures. What happens at that time, we should draw the figure and we should indicate only half portion hatching like this. Only half portion hatching means that half portion is asked like a sectioned figure. So this is very important factor. Every student should understand this. Next one is process sheet. This is again a very important factor for every production drawing question. So first of all, we need to understand that how to draw the process sheet. So the skeleton of the process sheet is very important. Drawing this table and indicating part number, description, material, size, quantity and time. This information above the table is very important and it carries compulsory marks. Next, maintaining the columns like serial number, machines, operation required, tools and gauges, and setup time and operation time. These are the columns very important for the process sheet. And we should indicate the name of the part which we are going to prepare the process sheet. In this non-written valve, we are producing this process sheet for the valve part. This is the valve part. So based on this position or shape of the valve part, we should prepare the process sheet. The first important thing in the process sheet is that we should go with the operations, and first important operation is that checking for the dimensions. When you are preparing any product, we should check the dimensions with the help of different measurements devices. Like here we are using vernier scale to check the dimensions. And the last operation is inspection. Inspect the final object. In between this, whatever the shape is there, according to that shape of the part, we'll do the operations on different machines with the different tools. Let's see, the first one is fix the job in the chuck and face on, means do the facing operation with facing tool. Fix the job in the chuck means in lathe machine. Next is turn the wings of diameter 90. Where is 90 diameter? This is 90 diameter. So turning the wings of 90 diameter with the turning tool on lathe machine only. Next to reverse the job. After reversing the job, machine the undercut with parting tool. Machining the undercut. Where the undercut is there, that machining is done with the parting tool. Next to turn the taper of 7 into 45 degrees. This is 7. Look at this. This is 7 number. So this gap is 7. This gap is 7 and this angle is 45. So 7 into 45 turning operation with the turning tool. Next to turn the radius of 100. Clearly mentioned 100 radius. This is 100 radius. So turning that 100 radius. Next to face to total length of 85. This side 48 plus 7 plus 5 plus 25. Total is 85. So face to the total length of 85 with facing tool. Doing the facing operation to this total 85 length. And finally inspect the element. Means after doing all the operations, final thing is that inspection. This is what about process sheet. So process sheet is going to indicate about the step-by-step procedure to produce a product, and this is very much helpful for the design engineers and civil engineers, so which can give the every detailed information to produce that object or design. Next table is the mating parts or type of fit table. So in this table, it shows the, what are the mating parts are there in non-written valve and what type of fit is called. First to see that body and cover. Body is the first part, second is cover. Those two are mating parts in this figure. So in this figure, body and cover are mating parts. Its type of fit is loose running fit. Second is body and wall seat. So body is the first part, wall seat is the sixth part. These two are mating parts. Its type of fit is close running. Next, third type is valve and valve seat. These two are mating parts. Valve and valve seat. Valve is fourth part, valve seat is sixth part. These two parts are mating parts. Its type of fit is easy running. So this table is about mating parts. So what type of fit is belongs to that mating parts. This is tolerance symbols table. So it shows some important number of symbols. Look at this. In this figure, here we have the two parallel lines, that is parallelism symbol. Here you can see parallelism symbol. Here you can see cylindricity symbol, this is cylindricity, and here you can see perpendicularity, this is perpendicularity symbol, and here you can see parallelism symbol, so this is parallelism symbol, and this is perpendicular symbol, so already we seen. So in this question we can see parallelism, this perpendicular symbol, so cylindricity, parallelism and perpendicular symbol, these three symbols used in this non-written valve. First of all, what is cylindricity means? It indicates the cylindrical object, and parallelism means two lines should be parallel, and perpendicularity means the two lines are 90 degrees to each other, so perpendicular, or simply you can say that tangent to each other. So these are the different symbols used for indication of tolerance. Next, indication of surface roughness symbols. Let's see, these are three different type of surface roughness symbol. First one is, it is a basic symbol, may be obtained by any production method. This is a basic symbol for production method. And the second symbol is, it is obtained by removal of material by machining. If any place is required like this, triangle symbol. This is triangle symbol. So wherever we can see this triangle symbol, that symbol is nothing but machining required symbol. This is machining required symbol. So this symbol indicates wherever the removal of the material by machining is required, this symbol is indicated. So this is what about surface roughness symbol. Thank you for watching this video. Do subscribe and share my videos. This is your Mahesh Dole.